Is God?
Can I say something to you? There's a Chinese man. Yeah. Just a video clip, right? So that we don't get too many wording. So what I have, I just want to thank God that I'm here for you. Right? So I just want to testify how the Spirit of the Lord is upon me. Because He appointed me, He anointed me to preach good news to the poor. He has sent me to proclaim release to the captives and recovery of sight to the blind, to see free those who are oppressed. The evidence that I'm going to share with you here today is regarding to this verse. Alright, a testimony that how God makes me half a millionaire when I only got $300 to turn $5,000. Wait. Let me read this scripture again, right? Isaiah and also in Luke, that was quoted by Luke himself. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me to bring good news. And how can I bring good news to a bunch of kids who has got zero neuro activity or zero neuro system? How can I talk to somebody who had David can say, wow, when he saw the word, and how can that good news be testified for one who been captive? What about parents going through those painful experiences? How can the oppressed see the glory of the Lord Jesus Christ upon us and bring that good news when all they see is pain and suffering? How can they see when they are blind? Alright, so now we're going to see a video of how autistic children declared and diagnosed totally zero in IQ level, 4-5%, zero in skill, zero in everything, but just being there have made a whole difference in their life. Alright, let's watch this video. Right, that exercise is quite heavy those days, that's how I so I make that changes. So one change can do is relax. Alright, so this is one of the exercises we do.
Okay, good. I'm going to let you be.
Yeah! Your mask door breaks over an azure sky. A group of
trained
paddlers strap up for what looks to be a splendid day
of
therapy.
Don't change.
Led by Pastor Andrew and his coaches, the group are a seasoned unit as they check for safety and launch without hesitation.
The
boys are calm. This touch of far beyond the eye can.
Red boy, the first one came.
I'm going to let you be.
Yeah! Your mask dawn breaks over an azure sky. A group of intrepid paddlers strap up for what looks to be a splendid day of ocean therapy. Led by Pastor Andrew and his coaches, the group are a seasoned unit as they check for safety and launch without hesitation. The waters are calm and stretch far beyond the eye can see. The route is about 5 kilometers and takes an hour to complete. As the paddlers glide into shore, smiles abound and all are renewed by the invigorating wind and gentle ebbing of the waves. This is Project Ocean Therapy, a ground-up initiative for children with autism. Join us and experience how the ocean embraces our community.
That's nice, huh? The Spirit of the Lord. He heals the broken heart. What you see there is the reality of our gospel. I've got nothing to share. This is what you witness. And I give God the glory.
Amen. Amen.
You. I have to make lots of changes. I have to fight against the authority because nobody believes me. When you see young paddling there,
this 17 years old with an IQ level of maybe 10%. He's diagnosed with zero motor skill, but today he pedaled 5 km. His neurodiversity begins to improve. Doctors question, did they diagnose wrongly? I say, when Jesus healed, no one can explain. That's a miracle. Amen. Amen. Then you see the boy, they say, I'm going for an SUP. The mother and parents have gone to all around the world getting for healing. But I told them, looking in captivity, just because you think there's some spiritual thing, why don't you just try a tablet? And she took one tablet, and Jonas is now talking. Are they open to the gospel? Yes, they are. The coach that goes, she's an atheist. At the end of the day, she came up to me, Pastor, can you pray for me? As these activities go on every Saturday and Tuesday, the Americans come family came up to me and said, can I be baptized? This is the first time in my entire ministry in the Presbyterian Church and down here in Crossway. I never experienced this in my whole entire life, where I don't have to do anything, but they came up to me, Pastor, are you a pastor? Can I be baptized? And they wear only a pair of bikinis, so my eyes had to be up in the sky. I didn't make you laugh so that you will not feel sleepy. So that is the evidence of His grace. That's why we are known as Grace Mission. Amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Oh, yeah.
What else can I speak when this verse became a reality? There's a boy. There's Jolene. He cannot even step onto the sand. But he paddled. His mother almost died of a heart attack. But today I think she's saved by the good God called Jesus. She attended church and began to go to the Lord in prayer. The whole family is there. That's grace. That is when the Spirit of the Lord is upon us to bring good news. So that is the good news that we bring to these people. Along the way, when you see all these people up there, God has brought back a lot of people. That's my bodybuilding pastor. Right, Pastor Kenji spent 7-8 years in prison. I never gave up on him, and everybody gave up on him. He's back to serve with us to go out to the gym. He's finished his physiology training. He went through whatever he needs to go through to become a better person, right?
Amen.
Amen. So he's heading our sports ministry for bodybuilders and physical fitness. And also to help me to train others in the physical business so that they can become strong, because you saw that, right? They're all very weak and all that. The Lord is using us mightily for them. Okay? And along the way, we are reaching out to, they call it beach bar bikini girls. So there's a boy named Moses. He came out to one of our, by the way, we have 3-generation pastor out there in the open sea, reaching out to the bikini girls. And it's me, 10 years older, and pastor, we call him pastor because we just want to be identified as a not that we want to be pastor, etc. We are there, we are known as pastor. So Moses came up to Pastor Billy, who's 10 years my junior. And he is 10 years Billy junior, so he's 40, 50, 60. So Moses went to see Pastor Billy and broke down in tears. He said, I used to be a very strong leader in the church group, but I have lost everything. And he broke down in tears and just crying out. Really said, Jesus forgives. Just come back. So today we are ministering to him now to be one of our committee members in the SUV Venture Club. You're reaching out to a lot of SGI boys and ACS boys that have backslidden. So the girl that going there also came back and I prayed for her and she began to see God in a very beautiful sense. So that's about ocean therapy. Today I am a businessman. I have never been a business in my life. I've been a chaplain, I've been a school teacher, I've been in a juvenile court trying to get kids out. I've been to fights. I don't know how come I'm staying alive. I'm known as pastor, gangster pastor, like your pastor. Now I'm known as pastor at the beach. So there was a girl standing there, and whenever anybody comes in, they will want to record our names and all that, right? As I go in, he called me father. What's in the lampe? So it's like in my heart. But I say, so respectfully, I say, yes, my father used to teach me the Bible, but he died and passed on. Today, no one teach me. Can I read the Bible again? I say, why not? Just download the apps. And that's what's happening there at the bar, at the restaurant, and everything. All right, so today, as a businessman, sports becomes our business. And that becomes our mission. So today, I have $500,000 asset up in the rooftop. Some of you there, aren't they?
That room, be careful, you'll fly away, huh?
Rooftop, that's right. So, yeah, the roof fly away. But not in Singapore. Some of you in the group chat, you know, right? So in Bohol and Bohol, I have our center.
Central Philippines.
Yeah, Central Philippines, so it was blown away, so no contact, so I can't say much about that. But nevertheless, the other thing that we do is an alternative restorative rehabilitation therapy out in the farm. I had $35,000 with the budget to pay the staff. I need a $35,000 plus another $20,000 plus another $70,000 to clear the land, $120,000. But then I stepped foot on the place that we were invited. Where our farm is today. I never think about anything. I step on it and say, from the glory of the morning, I shall praise the Lord, from the rising of the sun and the falling in the evening, blah, blah. I want the place. My accountant director said, Xiao Liao La! The next day, he find me, he's there, my wife there, because, right? I said, no, for this is the place where the glory of the Lord shall rise. Then when I check my pocket, I have chunked out for God. Man, I will find $500,000. But then the word of the Lord said, Allah. Sorry.
The word said Allah.
Jeremiah 17:7-9. Blessed is the man who trusts in the Lord, whosoever hopes in the Lord. He is like a tree planted beside water. My wife, good morning. A lot of waters that stretches out to the roots and to the stem. Wow, it fears not the heat when it comes in deep. Wow, see me here. Stay green. Wow, the leaves stay green in the heat. Wow, then I like the heat. Wow, so that's good. Yeah, it's not like you. It's like, what is God? In the year of drought, it shows no distress, but still bear fruit. Oh, I put this in my heart, I say, yes, Lord. This is all I have. Yeah. This is plastic. This plastic is plastic. This is plastic. But my one different. The root, the analogy here given by Jeremiah was the root. So the Lord reminded me of the roots that we have in Him. Yeah. The roots, our roots go deep into the Word of God that speak forth. Grace mission is but that little seed that speaks to the mountain and it shall be removed. I say the fear removed, put money in my pocket. Can you just imagine you go 35,000 balance you want to make?
没有做 business, all the businessmen there. Wow, beating, beat, no, beat. You know how much I beat? And you see. How much better? I say, free of charge. This is my plan, free of charge. And I was selected. Out of five business companies, one said they want to build satellite, don't know what, offer, wow, I don't know, $1.80 or $2.20 per square feet. I said, free of charge. But God said, whosoever is rooted, right? And I won. But I said, cannot free. I said, how much can you pay? I said, my pay, master pay, $8,500. Yes, I will. He said, okay. I said, yeah, yeah. I want to give God the glory to God. Why? Because I'm willing to give that 1,005. I'm willing to give all that we have and say, Lord, this is all I have. You shall multiply. And the Lord did that. So today, Grace Mission Agri Private Limited was established within 7 days. They asked me, what is the significance of grace? I said, it's my wife. She's the best support I have. They said, I'm so fast. Then, last point again, I won't take 15 minutes, don't worry. I took 3 minutes, 5 minutes, 5 minutes. Then, come the best part of me, to be charitable, right? Charity. I said, I'm charitable, can I? No, my ICP, PC, I said, IPC, I said, no need nah, all my donors come, they just give, never think about that. So, no choice, now we went to apply for Grace Mission Singapore Limited. The person who helped us say, there isn't any problem. It was just the name was approved. When they receive it, they said, go ahead. Wow, the fellow blow. Bro. Oh, after that, come bro. See me. Chong wa. Oh, bro. Ah, pass. Okay. Then we submitted. Then come here. Bro. Ah, bro. Okay, the bro. Answer a few questions. So answer again. Same question. What is the significance of the grace? I said, my wife. Do you have any mission book? I said, have one. Philippines. Okay, you must remember, don't preach gospel. I said, it's okay. I don't preach. I show. Show, right? Talk for what? You talk to the blind man. You talk to the mental health. You talk to the autistic buggy. See? So today I end by saying that the Lord provides everything. The Lord provides everything because I carry that message in the Word of God. I'm rooted in the Word of God. So today we have everything in place. The money is there. People ask me, did the church give? I said, the church never gave. It is the Lord. The giving came. You know how amazing? How many of you here raise funds for charity? Most of the time you go to the foundation, right? This is really God's gift. The foundation came to me and said, Andrew, now. I said, now I enter it. Now. Guess how much? $350,000. What's my one? How much? $150,000? Isn't that like mathematics? What's called pastor, $500,000, but not mine. For the pay bills. Alright, so that's all for me here today. Merry Christmas. May the Lord bless you. Let your roots be rooted into the Word of God. And remember this verse, for the Lord, the Spirit of the Lord is upon you and me to bring good news. Amen. Not our words. It is the Word of the Lord that brings good news, and you shall set the captives free, and you shall heal the blind, and you shall what? Raise the dead. I haven't yet. I bring people to the dead camp, but up project. Right, so we want to thank God for everything and thank you for listening to me. I hope I didn't bore you by anything. Right, so may the blessing of God be with you now and forever. Amen.